May the 4th is the day for Star Wars fans to show their love for the characters of the blockbuster hit movies.
That's right, and our reporter Dan Doody is dressed up for the occasion. Morning, mate, how are you?
Hello.
Oh, here he is.
Oh. May the 4th be with you. I am your father, and I'm also the daddy. Welcome to the dark side.
I love that.
Come over here. I want you to meet someone very, very special.
A perfect dismount.
Thank you. Hey guys, it's me!
Oh, wow, you had us fooled. Hey Daddy, how are you? Good morning.
Daddy Duty's here, and I'm joined by someone very special, a super fan, Deb. A very good morning. How are you going?
I'm going fantastic, thank you.
You're just a little bit of a fan.
Just a little. Oh. You know, as you can see.
Yes, look at all this collection and memorabilia. How did it all start for you?
Well, it started for me when I was really little, when my sister came home and said, I saw this amazing movie and here are some of the figures from it.
I did go on a
and
date.
It just grew from there.
Absolutely amazing. Bo, Sarah, you may think that this is the only one room, but we've got two other rooms. So three rooms, four rooms in total of Star Wars memorabilia. Mm. But can you tell us a little bit about some of the collection that you have here behind us?
Okay, so I'm really into Star Wars Lego and building them. It started with one of the Falcons in that case over there, and from there it just grew over the last 6 years. I cannot get enough of Star Wars Lego. Some of my favourites are the Technic droids, and I really like Bounty Hunters, so there's a lot of Slave Ones in this room as well.
Oh, fantastic. And what character are you dressed up this morning?
Okay, so this outfit is an Imperial officer outfit, and it's based on Admiral Darla, who is one of the Legends Admirals from the Star Wars books, from the novels.
And what do your family think about your obsession with Star Wars? I mean, you're not just a fan, you're a super fan. You're a mega fan. I was going to say super fan, but we'll go to the next level. You're a mega fan.
Yes, I am. So I'm also a deputy director of a Star Wars fan club. Mm. And I run the meetings for Star Wars fans in Sydney. And my family somewhat like Star Wars. One of my daughters absolutely loves Star Wars with the same passion that I do, but she doesn't live here. I think she wishes she did. And she cannot wait to have this as her inheritance. However, the other two don't mind it so much. They think I'm a little nuts. My mum, she does not understand at all. But my partner loves it as well. So that's really handy.
Hey, we all have to be a little bit crazy. We all have to have a bit of crazy in us. Now, just quickly, with the Star Walking group that you're in, it's you guys do charity events and so forth, and it's been around for 30 years.
Yes. So 1988 was a big year for Australia. So it was the bicentenary for Australia. But more importantly, it was the start of the Star Walking Club. And that club has been around for so long. It was based in Melbourne. That's where the head part is. We've now spread from Melbourne to Sydney and now in Brisbane as from this weekend. Well done, everyone. So we're becoming quite large. And we do charity work for children's charities, but we also have meetings where we meet up and we have live streams every month as well for people who live in remote areas so that they can mix and mingle with other people who have the same passion as we do.
Deb, it's absolutely amazing what you're doing. And I am going to test you a little bit later on, a Star Wars trivia, to see how well you know all things about Star Wars. Now, this is not a statue, Bo and Sarah. This is a real person. This is Deb's sister, okay? I like what you're wearing.
Very warm.
So stay tuned and we're going to... Yes, we're going
very
to tour
warm.
More of this fantastic place. May the 4th be with you.
Well,
or
done.
Force, Eddie. Is it? I'm not sure what it is.
It's May the 4th be with you, but it's May the 4th today.
Yeah, I love it. Back to you guys.
It's May the 4th, the official Star Wars Day, and our reporter Daniel Doody has found an Australian mega fan, Deb Clark, and he's taking a guided tour of some of the country's best collection of Star Wars memorabilia. Doody, happy Star Wars Day.
I want you to come and meet mega fan Deb. Deb, who are you this time? What character are you playing?
Well, my favourite character is Dengar. So sometimes people call me Devgar. So I'm a bounty hunter. You see me in Empire Strikes Back.
Now, we've just discovered that Deb is not a super fan. She's a mega fan of Star Wars, and we're in her place, and we're in her second room. You've got three rooms. Now, there's this card collection over here you can see here. Can you tell us a little bit about this card collection?
That is the complete collection of Star Wars cards. It has all, well, from the original trilogy, you have the New Hope, Empire Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi, every colour of every card. So gold, blue, red, you name it, it's in that collection. Some of them are quite expensive.
I was just going to ask you, it's worth a lot of money, some of those cards?
It sure is, and you can't take it with you.
I am not going to take it, I promise. All right, so can you tell us a little bit of some of the collection in this cabinet here?
Okay, so most people's favourite character is Boba Fett, who is also a bounty hunter. I don't particularly like Boba Fett. I like collecting Boba Fett, but Boba Fett is kind of my enemy if I'm going to be Dengar. So, you know, but we have random things. So my family and friends buy me different various things, and otherwise we buy them from collections. I have different series that I also am interested in. So, for example, I have some parts that are designated to Rebels, which is one of the cartoons. And then I have some a Darth Maul section, and I also have a Bounty Hunter section.
Oh, fantastic. Deb, what do you love about Star Wars Day?
I think it's amazing that of all the different hobbies or things that people could collect, that Star Wars gets its own day. There's no Star Trek Day. Sorry, guys. Sorry, Trekkies.
Apologies. Now, earlier I said I'm going to test your knowledge with all things Star Wars. Are you ready?
I think so.
Okay. All right. Sorry, it's not multiple choice. All right. But here we go. First question.
All right.
Who am I? What character am I, though?
Well, I'm not sure because Who's Your Daddy kind of threw me off a little bit. I would say a little bit of combination of Darth Vader and Princess Leia.
Ah, ding, 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 ding. You're right. Okay, here, next question. Who is the famous mentor of Luke Skywalker?
Well, Luke Skywalker was first trained by Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Correct.
However, also by Yoda.
Correct. All right. Now, this is worth $1 million, this next question. There's about $3 million in stake. How old is Yoda when he dies?
When you reach my age, yes, you get tired of training Jedis, he would be 900.
Yeah! Ding, 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 ding! In the first Death Star, what detention block was Princess Leia being held in?
Where were you held?
Yes, where was I held?
I believe...
Help me! Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! How was that?
Yeah, good night. I'd rescue you. So I believe it was AA-23.
Yes! Ding, 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 ding. And I'm just going to throw this one out here. What character am I when I do this sound?
You are either a Wookiee or Emperor Palpatine falling down the shaft at the end of Return of the Jedi.
Yes, I'm going to give that to you. Deb, it's been an absolutely pleasure seeing all your memorabilia and your collection. You and your partner have been doing this for 6 years, collecting all these Star Wars memorabilia. Is there anything that you want to say to the fans out there?
May the 4th be with you.
May the 4th be with you. Back to you guys in the studio.